This is Hanoi. So we are staying at this hotel tonight. Yeah, hello. Yeah. I'm starting to miss the countryside. Chaos of Hanoi is a little bit getting used to. I think because we go to sleep with the quiet and now coming back here with the city noise. So I'm glad I'm only here for a night. Come on. You know, I land here first, so this was the type of service I was used to. And then I get to Sapa and it was just Cause you know, it's a tourist town, so you kind of expect better, but no, no. Okay, come on, tea. Very good tea. So breakfast is included and you get 250,000 credit, drinking beverage credit to the sky bar. There's a sky bar up there. So this is the room. Service here is just 100% better. Let's do a tour of the room. Hello. Fridge, snacks, very nice and private toilet, and shower. Look at that, rain shower, nice. Wow, look at this espresso. Closet with the rope, safe, slipper and laundry bag. So tired. Really nice note, handwritten from the general manager. Excellent service so far. And this right here, the hot stone, so 620. So you put your clothes in there and they gave you this lockbox so you can put your phone and wallet and then you hold on to the key. Got the 75 minutes hot stone and it's really really hot. So you're not used to it, I don't really recommend it. Just get the Thero, whatever the oil thing. But after a week being frozen, it just felt really really good. I really like this place. I've been to a lot of massage, but this is really, really good. So I highly recommend it. Opera House. So this is a very popular boom chat place. Super crowded with tourists here. The reason why this place is so popular because Obama actually came here to and eat when he visited Vietnam. So that's why it's so popular. It's very sweet. This is a coffee shop. If you forget your toiletries, they get, these type of hotels would have this for you. And if they don't have it for you, then just ask the front. But most of the nicer hotel will have all of this for you. So if you forget your toiletry, don't worry. You're covered for at least a night. The water is hot. It is so refreshing to have hot water. When you turn it on, you don't have to wait 15 minutes for it. So... not feeling very well today. I think after 4 days of being in the back of the motorcycle in the rain and cold and 2 days of the craziness of Sapa, my body is telling me to like stop and take a break. So it's not feeling so good, but I need to go out and film this video. Hello. So this is the breakfast, not like that weird breakfast in Sapa where everything is empty. So soup. So it's a very westernized breakfast. Oh, sushi too. Vietnamese. Oh, I guess this right here is very Asian. And then you have pancake and French toast. The yogurt here is very good. I love this soju that meat is like kind of sour, but it's a good sour. Cereal, here are the pastry and fruits. This is the restaurant. The food here looks really, really good, but I don't feel like eating anything. But I will eat so we could get the day started. This is my breakfast. And they also have this menu right here too, if you want other food that's not here. So you could get pho, omelette, egg benedict. It's a very good selection of food. This yogurt is like one of my favorite things to eat in Vietnam. You can't get this anywhere else because the taste is very unique. It's like a sour yogurt. If you never had it before, I'd definitely give it a try. Before you come here, make sure you kind of plan where you're gonna go, what you wanna do. Kind of have an idea. That way I save a lot of time just like sitting around. Before I come in here, I have a folder on my Apple map. And it has all the places in Hanoi that I want to go to. Then you know exactly where you are. So you kind of have like a general idea of where you want to go, how far it is from where you are right now, and just kind of like plan your way around all the spots. So next, after breakfast, we're gonna go get egg coffee. I tried it the first time I was here, was that a week ago? Gosh, it seems like months ago. We're gonna try it again because this one is highly, highly recommended. I read somewhere it's like one of the highest rated egg coffee in Hanoi. So I'm gonna go there and give it another try because I did not like it the first time I tried it. And yeah, we're gonna see how many places we could hit up in one day and how much everything is gonna cost. Okay, let's say you have a day. So you fly in yesterday afternoon. So then you would have the afternoon to do whatever. I suggest going after you check into your hotel and get a little bit rested. Go to a massage, find a massage near you. Usually they all have massage in nicer hotels. The massage at the hotel will be more expensive. So if you don't care about pricing, then maybe that's a good place and you don't want to go anywhere. Whatever the case is, go get a massage, go get food, go get a drink. That's all you need to do. Then rest for the night and then the next day, have breakfast at the restaurant and then go explore the town. You just got in this morning and you're staying the night, then just do everything in reverse. Well, you're gonna see what I'm doing today, so hopefully that will make more sense. See you after breakfast. So the weather is kind of sucky right now, and we are gonna go to the egg coffee. I have my map up. You know, even though it's cold, it's not that bad. It's a little bit rainy. This is like the traffic in the small street. You just need to wait for the big car to go by and then just start walking very slowly. Don't run. And if a car or a motorcycle come right at you, just stop and don't panic. Well, you can panic on the inside, but don't panic on the outside. Don't try to run or anything like that. Just stay where you are and then the car and the motorcycle will go around you. So this is Hoang Kiem Lake right here. And it's a very, very famous lake. And you're gonna have these people asking if you want to ride, just say no. Humgang. Right now it's saying that I was supposed to be on this street, but it's actually the one street behind me. So this is 11. We are getting close. Oh, here we go. Found it. So that is the coffee shop up there on the second floor. These type of places are usually very good. So it's like the nicer looking one, or sometimes it's a hit and miss. But if it looks like this, chances are you're gonna get really good whatever you come here for. A lot of tourists. Nice. Jam the cafe jump. There's a balcony here. This is the inside of the cafe. Not very impressive looking. So this egg coffee costs 30,000. Thank you. So that is the egg coffee. How pretty. The top part is very eggy and the espresso is on the bottom. You can either stir it to mix it up. I kind of like to stir it up a little bit because the egg part is like really overwhelming. Mm. Very, very good. Let's mix it with some espresso. It is so good. And this is like 1/3 of the price of other places that I try. I highly recommend coming to this place. It got my stamp of approval, so definitely would come here again. charged me 25, even though the sign says 30. So sometimes it's nice to speak in Vietnamese and you get a little bit discount. We're gonna visit that temple over there. This temple is right on the lake. It's probably one of those tourist attractions. So you see a lot of foreigners here. Do you want more veggie? Come on, G. This is the ticket to get in. And it's very popular because it's right on the lake. So maybe you want to come here first and then go to the egg coffee if you start out your day early to avoid all this crowd. Come on, souvenir. Vietnamese New Year, chúc mừng năm mới. So this is the main shrine. Here is where you pray whatever you want to pray, health, wealth, luck, and then you place an incense in there. And this is a very common shrine. Every house kind of have that, their own shrine in Vietnam. Oof, no camera. So pretty. So beautiful, look at that. Decoration, two turtles. So they're just cleaning for the new year. So before the new year, everyone has to like do major cleaning. Everything has to be perfect. If you have bad luck during the new year or that day, you're gonna have bad luck for the whole year. So they're very, very superstitious about that. Here is the exit gate. So 50,000 is about $2. So I kind of recommend to just walk around and look at a little bit part of Vietnamese culture, because you kind of see how Vietnamese people worship in there. It's very extravagant, like super extravagant. Now we have to think about what we're gonna do. My hotel is right across the street. So we're gonna try to get through this crazy traffic again. Remember, steady pace. Look for a gap and then go, but don't run. Just go very slowly. So yeah, just very slowly and look at them. Here is my hotel, and it's really, really conveniently located. The temple we were just at is over there. So I highly recommend this hotel, and the service is very good. Or stay anywhere near this area would be very good. Okay, let's go find something to do. So if you're walking around, make sure you save your hotel location on your map or whatever app you're using. If you walk a lot, you could always map it back to your hotel. I use the Gaia app. It's a really, really great app because it tracks where I'm going, so I can like kind of look at it and then find my way back home. So I recommend if you're just like walking around town or even on a road trip, using that app is really, really nice to be able to track where you've been and find your way back. Places like this where you can exchange money and book your tour. But I have a wonderful booker that I will be linking below. And then for exchanging money, I recommend going to a gold store. If a gold store is inconvenient for you, then find a bank. Usually the exchange rate is better than those type of places. So right here is the snail place.
So we are here, and I am going to order some snails.
Do you like an eddy? So I order the snails right here. He recommend that one. Saute in garlic. And then I also order this right here, Thai style clam.
So good in on this cold day.
That is the smooth meal right there.
Very unique flavor. So the outer shell actually has flat flavor.
Very good. This is very good. Total is $2.90. Okay, have to go back to the hotel because I have to check out. And then we're gonna get on the motorcycle because I don't have a lot of time here.
Ticket for the suitcase.
If you check out and you kept your suitcases here and you're going around town, you could come back here, take a shower, not inside the room, but have a special shower place for you to shower and then get on the plane or wherever you're going. So
So it's a really nice service, and this is the only hotel that I stayed in so far that have that. So really, really highly recommend this hotel if you are going to Hanoi.
I should be wearing a helmet.
So we will eat here. This is Mung Rieu, very famous dish in Vietnam, and there are a lot of people here, so it must be very, very good. That's the kitchen right there.
So that is the price right there.
So this is Mung Rieu combination with everything.
Egg in here. I've never had Mung Rieu like this before.
Traveling to the next stop. Okay, so we're gonna go up to this coffee shop up here and then look down at the traffic down there. This is the place that we went yesterday. This is the view of this. Very nice. And this is the view of the outside from up here. And that is the temple we were just at this morning. Boba in Vietnam.
Very good. Wow.
So that is where we were just in, on the fifth floor right there, looking down in all of this chaos. This is Hanoi. And this is the old church. This whole street is selling Vietnamese flour right now. So if you ever in Vietnam around at times, then I recommend checking this street out. It's worth to spend probably 10-20 minutes here because it's really, really fascinating. So the street right now is called Jo Hoang because they're selling all these type of flowers. The flower tree and this tree is the main trees for Viet. So this is why it is called the Red Street, or I call it the Red Street. Look how pretty. These are candy. And it's even prettier at night because all the lights get lit up. This is Bali Sea. You put money and then you give it to people. Mainly little kids, usually. Or people that are not married. Một cái bao là bao nhiêu vậy chị?
Ờ, cái đấy 15.000 một tập.
15.000 hả?
Bên này là 10.000
thôi nè. Okay. I bought it for 8,000 in Hoa, and here they're selling it for 15, so almost double. Detailing on this one is amazing. They put this up around the house for decoration, like kind of Christmas. They're doing a TikTok commercial right now. I'm gonna order this me place right here. It's on one of my lists. It's the menu, and over here is the drink menu. So I got a combination for a traditional banh mi. So bread and drink. This is the service you would get here. Come on.
And we're just waiting for the luggage. So I'm gonna leave to the airport a little bit early since the traffic is gonna be crazy and I just wanna get some work done.
Yeah, come on in. No. Hello.
So now we say bye to Hanoi. Going to the airport to go to Hoa.
I am so tired. My body is definitely breaking down. I'm gonna sleep all day tomorrow. I feel like I've been here for months and it's only been like 2.5 weeks, 3 weeks, I think. So I'm gonna get this drink here.
Come on.
Thank you for watching. Until next time.